Hi guys, Colesy, and today I want to talk to you and show and unbox something that I have bought, a Nintendo product. It is this, the N64 controller for the Nintendo Switch. I was super excited when I found out that they were doing N64 games on the Switch, because N64 was the console that I grew up with. It was my first console. It was what I played Ocarina of Time on, one of my favorite games of all time. I have some amazing, just nostalgic memories of that game and just that console in general. So obviously when they were bringing N64 games to the Switch, I was in. I was always going to buy the expansion pass, but I figured I'd treat myself and actually get the controller for a little bit of extra nostalgia, because I, you know, it's my first console, so I kind of had to buy it. Had this for a while. I've been a bit sick and I had a silly voice, so I wasn't able to unbox it or play with it. Well, I could have played with it, but I didn't want to play with it without recording my actual first impressions and unboxing of it. I guess here we are. Today's video is brought to you by Audible. Audible has the world's largest selection of audiobooks as well as podcasts and exclusive originals. And today for you guys, Audible are offering a free trial for 30 days where you can receive one free audiobook of your choosing absolutely free. All you have to do is check the link in the description. If you're like me, you listen to a lot of podcasts and audiobooks when you're on the go, and even maybe while you're trying to get to sleep. I know I do. I like to listen to something as I drift off into the land of dreams. Go check out Audible. Link, like I said, is in the description. Get yourself one free audiobook. Cost you absolutely nothing. Cancel anytime. But thank you, Audible, for sponsoring today's video. Okie dokie. All right, so here, this is a genuine, normal, standard, everyday old N64 controller. It's actually quite dusty because I haven't used it for a while because I don't know where the N64 is. But there you go. It's got the old connector on it, that little thing. They're very light. They're very light, or maybe this is not. I don't think this is actually a genuine Nintendo one. It doesn't say Nintendo on it. People always think how weird these controllers were because it's got kind of like the three handles. Like you hold it like that, or do you hold it like this? I was always a this guy. This was how I held it. You got to have a thumb on the stick, and then you have your thumb over here in the buttons, and then the D-pad. I mean, you're just gonna reach for the D-pad if you want it. It's got your expansion port, which I believe you could put a vibration thing in it. Expansion card, I guess. I'm not entirely sure what else you could put in it. I can't remember. It has been a while since I've actually played with an N64, so I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited to open this new controller. So that's the original N64 controller. It's time to open the actual new Switch controller. I'm gonna try and not make a mess of the box, if I can possibly not make a mess of the box, because I'm one of those people that kind of likes to keep the boxes if I can. I dropped half of it, but I didn't drop the controller. This bit just slid out. To actually get hands-on with the controller. So this is it. See, it says Nintendo here, whereas this one does not say Nintendo. They're actually, I mean, it's very, very similar looking, isn't it? I mean, it's gonna be, because it is the same controller, but they do look very similar. Obviously, this one's sort of, the Switch one is heavier because I assume it's got a lot of, it's got a lot more stuff in it because it's got USB-C, Bluetooth, in this one, whereas this one was, you know, literally you just plugged it in and then you had space for your expansion slots and stuff, whereas this one, I guess, is just, it just has the slot, but it's filled. So this was the thing with the N64 controllers. The sticks always went a bit crappy, didn't they? I think that was the thing. This one actually feels fairly good. This is the old one, obviously, although it did click a bit there, but yeah, this one feels not too bad. But the new one, it's obviously lot nicer. They've had time to figure this out and it's like a lot springier, so I guess hopefully the sticks won't go on this new one. We got a manual in the box, which you don't really need, a USB-C cable to plug it into the Switch should we need to. Maybe I will just take a look at the manual to make sure I connect this thing correctly. Removing the battery. The battery should be removed by a qualified professional. Wasn't planning on doing that, but okay. We may as well go through the little pairing process just to show you guys. Hopefully it'll be simple and easy. All right, so we need to go to controllers, which is pretty standard as to how we connect controllers anyway. Change grip order. Hold the sync button on the controller. When the controller is paired, the LED will change solid. Holding the sync button. That was it. Okay, that was possibly, well, I mean, that was very simple. Right, so I can use the D-pad, I guess, to navigate. I can also use the stick to navigate. That's pretty cool. I like the way it shows up as an N64 controller. I'm getting kind of giddy at the fact that it shows up as an N64 controller. It looks awesome. I'm gonna whack on my headphones real quick. And now, let's jump into the N64 Nintendo Switch Online as me. These are the games that we have access to at the minute. I hope they're going to update this, and I probably will make a video talking about the N64 games on the Switch and stuff, and this expansion pass as a separate video, because like I said, this video, I want to focus on it being about the controller. I'm not going to go on Ocarina of Time, saving that for a live stream. So if you want to catch those live streams, go to twitch.tv/ColesyGaming, and that's where I'll be streaming it when I get a chance to stream. And I'll edit those for videos probably as well. But if you want to catch them live, that's where you want to be. But for today, we'll play Mario Kart, because it is the only game that I've actually played so far. I was testing a different controller. Let's do 100cc. Let's not go crazy here. It has been a while. I'm gonna be Mario. What's the buttons? What's the go button? Okay, it's A. Okay. Oh my god, okay. So this controls a little bit different to how you probably have played Mario Kart recently, because this is old Mario Kart. This is not Mario Kart 8 Deluxe on the Switch. Feels fine. The controller feels great. I'm not noticing any, like, input lag or anything like that. I'm not good at the game, but that's a whole different thing. Get zapped, everybody! Oh, squished you, Peach! Oh. Jesus. What the hell was that? Squished you, Bowser. Oh, God, I'm on the grass. What the hell was that? Oh, Peach is back. God damn it. I'm just gonna play this one race. I'm not gonna do all of them. Save you guys time. God, you didn't come here to watch a Mario Kart 64 Let's Play. I don't think you did anyway. Maybe you did. Ah, boat! What a weird way to land, that is. You land and then you turn 90 degrees. Toad's been messed up. Great. Puts me into second. Oh, God. I'm going to need to boost out of this. I screwed that up. Toad, out my way! Oh, there's Wario. Oh, God damn it. Nana in my way. Toad, screw off. Oh, he's gonna beat me, isn't he? No! God. Well, that was fourth. That was... Okay. Well. Not my best work, but there we go. Right. This controller is not necessary, and I know that. But just for the nostalgia aspect, and because I want to play these N64 games, I want to do it with an actual controller. So for me, it was worth buying as like a little nostalgia trip. In Ocarina of Time, you have your items on the yellow buttons. The fact that I actually am going to have the yellow buttons there, and it's going to be exactly how it was when I was a kid, is super cool. So it was worth it for me. I think it was like £40. So it wasn't that expensive. I mean, a pair of Joy-Cons is probably more than that anyway. So for me, worth it. That's pretty much the video. I mean, there's not really much to unbox. It was a controller with a cable, and it works like you think it would. It should have more weight to it than the old controllers, because it's, you know, it's got a bunch of new tech in it and stuff, and it is a bit heftier than the old controller is. But it feels just as good as the old controller does, in my opinion. Some people hate this controller, but I really like it. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this. If you want to catch me, like I said, playing some of the N64 games at twitch.tv/ColesyGaming, I'm going to be playing fully through Ocarina of Time using my new N64 controller, because that's what it's for. If you guys would like to see me make a video talking more about the expansion pass, I know that there's a lot of debate whether it's good or not, whether the performance is there, whether it's worth the extra money. I'm gonna leave some time to let me actually play through these games a little bit and kind of get used to how they feel, and then actually come up with my own opinion. Obviously, I'm excited about N64 games coming to the Switch, but if the quality of them is not good and the performance of them is not good, then that's obviously not good. And I'm quite happy to say that it's not good if it isn't good. I'm not going to be one of those people that's like, just because it's nostalgic, I'm going to say it's great. No, there's going to be an aspect of that that makes me think, oh, the fact that I can actually play Ocarina of Time on my Switch is really cool, but I want it to play at least decently. Don't want to go too much into that now. That will be a separate video that I will make in the future at some point. Thank you guys for watching. I really hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think. Did you grab yourselves one of these? I know that the Genesis came out with a controller as well. Are you excited about that? What would you like to see coming to the Switch, either on the N64 or the Genesis, or maybe even more games like GameCube? Would you like to see that come in? Let me know in the comments. Let's start a conversation. Have chat in the comments. That's what it's for. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you next time.